It came as a complete bombshell.
I would like to update you. A very important security update.
But the Israeli Prime Minister's security update revealed more about the mystery of missing Air Force navigator Ron Arad, or more accurately, about the efforts to solve it.
Last month, Mossad agents embarked on a mission to find new information on the fate and whereabouts of Ron Arad. It was a complex and wide-ranging operation. This is all I can reveal at the moment. We made further efforts on the path to understanding Ron's fate.
Arad was captured in 1986 and in the first years was moved around, transferred from the Lebanese Amal movement to the Iranians and Hezbollah. But since 1988, no sign of life has been received. A secret committee set up in Israeli intelligence to determine what happened to him concluded he's no longer alive. His burial place unknown.
There were always tremendous efforts, turning every stone, always. Israel never stopped doing that, and there was nothing that wasn't given for this task. The State of Israel has always invested the best to bring Ron Arad home or solve his mystery.
Mere hours after the premier's revelation, the Lebanese newspaper al-Youm reported the Mossad abducted an Iranian general in Syria as part of the operation, saying the Iranian official was forcibly taken to a country in Africa, questioned about new information on the whereabouts of the missing Air Force pilot, and then released. Then the Saudi Arabia network reported the Mossad extracted DNA from a body whose remains were found in a village in southern Lebanon in order to check whether it belonged to Arad. Mossad chief Teddy Barnea was quoted as saying after the expose that
it was a brave, daring, complex operation, but a failure. It was a failure, but we will continue our efforts.
But not everyone were impressed by the revelation.
My opinion on the matter is well known. I'm against publishing and against talking about Mossad operations. I think that in the context of the prisoners and missing people we have in Gaza, the Prime Minister wanted to show that the efforts always continue.
Next weekend will mark the 35th anniversary of Arad's capture, but Israel, it seems, is still determined, so many years after, to get some clarity and maybe closure.